Hey guys, it's Nicole. Welcome back to my channel. We have a Goodwill outlet haul for you today. It's been a while since I did a haul. I've actually filmed a few hauls, but this is gonna be the first one that I put up since I put up that video talking about how I made $1,000 in a day after my 6 month break from social media. So, it's exciting. I have a lot of work to do still, I know, within the community, but I'm here. We're not gonna go backwards. We're gonna go forwards. We're not gonna talk about the past. We're gonna move forward. That's all we can do at this point. I can do at this point. Okay, this Goodwill outlet haul is not my best haul, you guys. But it is a crazy story that I think you'll enjoy. So I'll tell you. So I went to the Goodwill outlet, which is a pay by the pound Goodwill. And I ended up spending just about an hour there. I spent $41.54 on my items, 32 pounds at $1.29 a pound. But there's a story here. So drop off my kids at school. I drive to the outlet. Get to the outlet and my headphones aren't working and I hate being at the bench without headphones. I need headphones. I need to be focused. So I sit in my car for about 20 minutes to charge up my headphones and I go in around 9 o'clock, 9:15 is when I would say that I got in there. 9:15, 9:30, okay? So I start shopping and I get a call from my kid's school. And the school is like, hey, there was smoke in the building. The kids are outside. Don't come to the school. Everything is fine. They're just gonna have an extended recess. That's what the call and text message that I got said. So put my headphones in and I started shopping. Okay, started shopping. Then I start getting a bunch of calls and text messages all of a sudden. The school is on fire. I need to leave. I need to go pick up my kids. Everyone is okay, everyone is safe, but there was an electrical fire and I had to immediately leave. So this haul is not the best because there was literally a fire at my kid's school, but it worked out. I still, you have to get 25 pounds to make it the dollar a pound. Otherwise it's like two something a pound. So I got to the register at checkout and it was only 23 pounds. So I literally went and grabbed this giant heavy basket, added a few more pounds to my haul so I could check out. So really clothing wise, there's really only about 23 pounds here. So I just want to take that into account when it comes to cost averaging out my haul. Let's dive into the haul. So we have a couple loose things over here and I'm going to sell all this stuff, on probably Poshmark, Macari, a local children's consignment sale that I do. There's a few ways I'll talk about it as I go here, but that $41 that I spent, I should be able to turn it into at least $300, I would say at minimum, hopefully a little bit more. Okay, so my family's gotten really into hockey. My daughter's playing hockey now. And for the past 6 months, our family has totally been like really into hockey. It's a thing now that we do together. So I saw this New York Islanders hat, which is not my hockey team, but you know, and now when I see these things, I feel like I need to pick them up. So I grabbed this. I should be able to sell it for $15 or $20. It is a cool little hat. I picked up this, and this is just a round kind of blanket Turkish towel from Opal House, which is Target. But I will pick up some Target Opal House stuff because it does have a following. And some of it sells really well. I just sold a blanket for, I think, like $30. So I'll pick it up. But also I was like, oh, this isn't an item that will sell. I will absolutely just use this this summer outside. We go on like hikes or to the beach or whatever. So I grabbed this. I'll look it up, see if it's worth selling. And if not, I'll keep it. It doesn't weigh very much. It's very lightweight. So I probably only paid $1 or $2 for it. I do have some kid stuff, which I've separated out because this stuff will all go in the local children's consignment sale that I do 2 times a year. The next one is coming up in April. And so I have quite a few buckets already. I'm hoping to put about 300 items into that sale and I do pretty well with it. So It actually paid for all of our Christmas presents in December this year doing that sale. So this is the first item. This is just a little Tucker and Tate plaid blouse. Little swing top, put little shorts under this. It's perfect. Tucker and Tate is just a Nordstrom house brand, I believe. But I'll put this in the sale, make it $1. A little Columbia beanie. And these are actually riding pants. So I might sell these on Poshmark or I might just put them in the sale. It depends. I'm gonna look up comps, but I do always pick up this brand when I see it. Here is the tag. It is by the brand Carrots. So if you see Carrot stuff, adult or children's, I would pick it up. Historically, I've done really well. So pick that stuff up. We have a swimsuit from Speedo. When you are buying kids swimsuits, there's a few things to always be looking at, mostly the behind area, because kids sit on like the side of pools or in the sand, and this area can get really like peely and gross, and the rest of the swimsuit can look great, but always double check. This one didn't have anything wrong with it, so I went ahead and grabbed it. And then we have this little outfit. So it's a little boys Bowden polo shirt and the matching shorts. I could probably sell these on Poshmark, and maybe I will, who knows? It depends on my inventory level. My inventory runs low. I can grab things like this and list it for $25 for the set, but it's easier for me to just put in the kids' sale, so we'll see how that goes. Okay. Oh, the last kid item I got is actually this basket. This is a snow helmet for like skiing or snowboarding. This is the brand, and it is a very expensive helmet. This one looks like it's in brand new condition. And I don't know, helmets can be weird to sell. So I don't know, we'll see. There was a lot of these listed on Poshmark, and I grabbed it and I put it in my cart. And it looks like they sell for a decent amount of money. So we'll see if I list that or not. Because I don't know like what's happened in the lifetime of this helmet. It's debatable. Okay. This is a wrap of the program. First item is a Pendleton flannel, and it is a double line, or what is the word? It's like a word for it. Anyway, it's a flannel or a shacket or whatever you want it to be. But there it is, the logo, and I thought this was really cool, so I grabbed that. You guys have, I met my new dog, she's in here. Oh, there you go, this is Seven. Hi, say hi, Seven. Hi. We lost my other dog, Sophie, to cancer and adopted Seven. Love her. We miss Sophie. We love Seven. But anyway, that's Seven. She's in here. Milling around, in case you guys hear a weird sound like her shaking her head. Star Wars. So this is just on the buys, which I, you know, I don't normally usually pass on this, but Star Wars stuff can do good. I will put good keywords in this, like Disneyland, all of that good stuff, and hopefully someone will want this and needs to be washed. I'm gonna wash all this stuff once I'm done with the haul. This is a We the Free by Free People waffle knit shirt. I've sold this a bunch of times. It'll be easy to list. And this one is a size small. But as you know, in Free People land, that doesn't mean much. Okay, this was my favorite item that I got. And honestly, I might have walked out with nothing if I hadn't have found this when I got the text message to come pick up the kids. But this was a really good find. And so decided to check out. So this is a Trip NYC. And before I get criticism, the kids were fine. They were like at a park far away from the school. Everyone was fine. The teacher was like, come as soon as you can, but like no rush. So I wasn't like putting off my kids to finish checking out at Goodwill. Everyone was okay. They were outside having fun. They were sad when I showed up because they wanted to stay and keep playing. It wasn't there was no like immediate danger for anyone. Trip NYC This is a, I believe it's a men's jacket, but their plaid like pants and skirts and stuff can do really, really well. Someone wore it. Celebrities have worn it recently and it totally made the price go up. So this was a good find. Hopefully I'll be able to sell that for $50 to $75. I haven't checked comps, but that's my hope. This is just a North Face jacket. This is an older North Face jacket. It's not the best by any means, but it's a nice soft shell jacket. There is the North Face logo. You can see it's like a floral print, a woman small, and it's in really good condition. There was no flaws that I could see. I'll give it a quick wash. And let's see, my Goodwill wanted $15 for it. No one bought it, so it ended up at the bins. And hopefully I can sell it for $30 to $40. Okay, a pair of Nike pants, just a pair of Nike jogger sweatpants. Nothing too fancy, but $20 is probably what those will sell for. We have this. This is just three dots. And it's a really fun, like, crinkle shirt, button-down shirt. Nice, lightweight. This is good for that upcoming spring, summer months. Most of these items are like $20 items, but it all adds up. You know, I only spent $40. So by the time I sell two or three items, I've made my money back and the rest is profit. Yes, I have to spend more time listing. I can list really fast, so that's fine for me. This is Michael Stars, and Michael Stars is hit and miss. So it retails for a lot. This should probably retail for $100. Resale value, nah, not that much. But sometimes I still pick it up, especially if it's in really good condition. This is a lightweight, longer shirt, and I'll price it at $20 to $25 and hopefully find a home. I did just sell a Michael Stars shirt a couple days ago, and it was only listed for a couple days. So, you know, I think that sometimes it's okay to pick the stuff up, even if it sits for a little bit longer. This is a Garnet Hill dress. And I'm starting to think of spring and summer now when I'm sourcing. I bought this because I don't buy all Garnet Hill stuff, but I did get this one. Here's a few reasons. A, it's a size extra large, which is a great size. It is a nice basic dress, and it is 100% organic cotton. So all of those things should equal a nice sell. And it does have the style number on it, so it'll be easy to look up. I think it will do well. I think I'll probably be able to get $25 to $30 for that. These are all estimates. Okay, this piece I bought because of the size. So this is a nice, thicker material. This is a brand from Nordstrom. It's like a Nordstrom House brand, Sigjor. And it's a size 16. And it's just like a really nice career sheath dress. It is, I think it's like a midi knee length, depending on your height. I'm tall, so anything that's like knee length on me sometimes is actually a midi dress, and I have to remember these things. So I think that I don't always pick up this brand, but a good basic closet staple like this one, I'll pick up in the right sizes. This is a Columbia Outdoors shirt, and it is a large men's sun protectant shirt. It has venting. I've been picking up stuff like this for years. Always sells. It's not gonna sell for a lot, $15, $20. But again, that's okay for me. These are a pair of J. Crew classic dress pants. A couple reasons I bought these. A, they have a really nice fabric. And B, they have the name and they are a size 12, so they will be easy to list. So let's see here. I'm trying to see. They are older, I guess. Yeah, they are from 2015, but this is just such a classic style that I'll still pick it up. I don't know why I bought this, but I did. So here it is. This is an American Eagle basic t-shirt. And it does have distressing on it, like the little holes and rips are intentional. And it's a size small. I don't know why I bought this. It was very lightweight, and I'll list it for $15, or I'll hold on to it and see if I find a couple more American Eagle size small shirts that I can lot it up with. At the bins, that's typically what I'll do, is like, you know, one person will donate their whole closet and you'll find a bunch of it in a bin. So I'll buy a bunch of the same sizes and you can lot them up, but who knows? This is a foot haul because I was in a rush. Okay, this is a Champion sweatshirt, Champion Originals. This is a size 2X, and it's just a great crew neck. But it will probably sell for $20 or $25, and that's kind of my goal when I'm at the bins. This is another one where I'm like, I should have dumped this back in my cart. Why did I get this? It's just like a really basic piece. So Prana, I will buy. But okay, a couple things about this. This is a size small, which is the like small and extra small for me and my closet personally. I try and have a wide variety of sizes, and smalls and extra smalls are the sizes that just don't sell as fast for me. So those pieces I feel like need to be a little bit specialer. Is that even a word? Specialer? More special? I don't know. And this just isn't. It's an older piece, and it'll probably sell again for $15 or $20. It's kind of like that American Eagle shirt. I guess it will sell, but it's not something. It will take a minute, and it's a very oversaturated market. Now, Prana, I will buy like their dresses, their jackets. There's lots of things I will buy from this brand. Just a basic size small shirt and kind of an outdated cut is not something I would buy. But I have it. Okay, these were fun. This is a very old J. Crew tag. I usually don't buy anything with this J. Crew tag. So look, but there is exceptions to every rule. See if it will show up. There it is. There's exceptions to every rule, and this is one of those times where I took an exception. So this is a J. Crew long john pajama with, look at this, it has the butt opening. So this was just too fun, and just based on the style alone, I knew I had to get it. Fun pajamas like this, especially during like ski season, these usually sell for me. So grab that, I'll list it at like $25 or so. This was just fun. This is a little Zara romper. We're not making $1 million off this haul, guys, but it will do okay. And this one is also an extra small, but I thought this was really fun for spring and summer coming up. And Zara is pretty easy to list, and while it does have a pretty oversaturated market, the items still sell for me, especially if I can go on like to know it and find a good photo of an influencer wearing the item and use that as my cover photo. It usually works out well. So I've noticed a lot of people on Poshmark have started to do that, and I have for a few things, and it does well. You know, it shows like a different angle of the item. What are you chewing right now? Stop it. No. Oh my gosh, why? No, this wasn't supposed to be on the ground. This is my Disneyland Tiki Man. My dog just ate it. Why did you do that? This is so sad. I'm really upset with you right now. Okay, back to the haul. She's two. We adopted her. She's pretty good, but she only eats things that I love, like my chopsticks, and candy, and apparently my Disneyland figure that I bought at the park, and it had memories attached to it. She doesn't eat like shoes or socks or anyone else's stuff, just mine. Nice of her. I really do love her though. She's like been the best thing that happened to our family. Okay, American Eagle button down shirt. I just like this shirt. It's like a flannel. I can also, you know, you can style this open, call it a shacket, use some good keywords. Grab that. These need to be washed, but these are just men's swim trunks from Brixton. There's a logo right there. Come on, you can do it better than that. You can do it. Well, you guys get the point. These are Brixton men's swim trunks. And they have like a little surfer pinup girl on them. Okay. Another one of those items where I really should have looked it up, but I ran out of time and it was in my cart and I wanted to make weight, so I bought it. Now, when I first started reselling full time, almost seven years ago, I would have been thrilled to find this. Now, I don't know. I haven't looked it up yet. I did this video before I looked it up. But I don't think this is a thing that people want anymore, but I have it. So this is by Covet. Yes. And they make a lot of like art to wear stuff. Back in the day, I would have been thrilled to find this. I don't know if anyone wants it, like I said, but I have it and I'm gonna list it and we're gonna see what happens. That's the joy of the bins. What are these? These are just Nike golf pants and they are a size 36. Shorts. Why did I say pants? Hi. Nike golf shorts. There we go. Size 36 and we'll send for $20. They'll sell. That's a good basic. These are just a pair of Levi's. They are the premium. They have the premium tag in them. Where are you? There we go. So we'll get these listed. A Nike fleece butterfly cape. These used to be the hot tip when I first started reselling. This is another one of those items I would have been over the moon to find. I used to buy these at regular Goodwills for like $10 or $15, sell them for $30 to $40, like all day long. Now, you know, they're not as in style, but I'll still pick it up at the bins and I should still be able to sell for $20. And then I have a, last but not least here, just a little Cabbie shirt. This is not something that I would pick up anywhere but the bins. I feel like Cabbie's pretty oversaturated and there's certain pieces that sell well, but it's kind of run its course. But here it is, newer tag. You can't even say newer tag. Okay, that's how long I've been reselling. If this is not new tag Cabbie, and this is the current tag Cabbie when you started reselling, I'm sorry. But they switched tags when a year or two into when I started reselling. And when you found this tag, it was like such a bolo and so exciting. Now a basic shirt, this is like $15, but I will list it, it will sell, and it all adds up. It all adds up. And right now I feel like a lot of people are more willing to spend on those $20 items than they are on the more expensive items. There's a lot of uncertainty in the world. And so having those lower dollar items, that's what's selling for me. And so I'm going to keep picking it up. I'm going to keep going. And yeah, that's about it. and then I have my beautiful basket. My beautiful heavy basket, which I'm going to put in my little mud room area for the kids to throw clothes in after school. They go to a Waldorf school, and so they go outside every day, rain or shine. They always come home covered in mud and dirt, and I have to have an area for them to change before they can come in the house. So I'm looking for a nice big basket like this. This will work great. So it all worked out. I had to buy something. Once again, that will do. It's not exactly what I was looking for, but it will do the trick. Got it for a couple bucks. And we're good to go. Anyway, thanks for watching this video today, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I know this wasn't like anything to write home about haul-wise, but I was only in the Goodwill outlet for an hour and this is what I was able to find. And that's what happens sometimes. Sometimes you don't have a lot of time. You're not finding all kinds of gems and amazing items. Not every haul is going to be this masterpiece of a haul. A lot of times your hauls from the outlet look like this. I think I counted like 30 pieces. So even if I average $20, my average sell is like $20. That's still $600, right? I think that I'll get more like $300 or $400 out of this haul. And that's not bad. That's not bad. When you can turn 40 into 300, I'll do that all day long. Yes, it's gonna take a little bit of work. I have to wash everything, I have to list everything, but I can list 50 items in a day pretty easily at this point in my career, just from like pure muscle memory. And I have, you know, I just go. So that works out, it's fine. And we better go. I'm gonna go get to work. Thanks for watching this video. I'll be back again soon, probably with another video. I have a bunch of hauls already filmed that I need to put up, but who knows what order I'll put them up. I'm still me. Thanks for watching, you guys. Have a great day. Bye.